your function. I just needed us guys to go back into the beginning, okay, so that you would be reminded that each of the function of your liver may corresponding siya na test. So kunwari, paano mo malalaman na, 'di ba kunwari, paano mo malalaman na mainit na sa isang lugar? You would use thermometer. Paano mo malalaman na yung speed ng hangin ay malakas? You would use barometer. 'Di ba? Paano mo naman malalaman na yung synthetic function ng liver ay tama pa? How would you know that the detoxification function is still functioning well? How would you know that the conjugation, the excretion, secretion, the storage function of your liver is still functioning well? Well, for today, we're going to discuss the assessment of your liver function. And to start with, we will be going directly into measuring the conjugation function of your liver. Okay? Lagi kang ito yung gusto kong matandaan ninyo, ha? Na if you're going to go back and if people would ask you what is the most important test for your liver, okay, what is the most important test for your liver, you would always revolve into their function. Okay, kung ano yung function ng liver, yun yung itetest mo. Parang sa kidney, ang function ni kidney is to filter, to excrete the waste. How would you able to know kumusta si liver, I think kidney, to check its kidney function test? Creatinine, uric acid, to name a few. Ganun din pagdating kay liver. So right now, okay, ganun din pagdating kay liver. Naalala ko tuloy si liver. Okay, hindi ko nakikita ang kanyang perfect na kilay ng ilang araw na. So liver, baka naman. Okay? So moving forward, let's go to the conjugation function of your liver. Okay? When we talk about the conjugation function, we are identifying the ability of your liver to conjugate your bilirubin. Okay? To conjugate your bilirubin. So, first and foremost, serum specimen should be free from hemolysis and lipemia. That's why it's actually best if you would have your fasting. Why? Because hemolysis, of course, can liberate your hemoglobin, can liberate your heme, that can also pose an increase in your bilirubin levels. Tama? Lipemia, bakit lipemia ay problema? Dahil magkukos siya ng turbidity. Okay? Magkukos siya ng turbidity. So, serum should be stored in dark. Okay? Ito yung napaka-importante nito. It should be stored in dark and should be measured ASAP or within 2 to 3 hours after collection. Question, why is it that number 2 bullet is a requirement? Anyone from the class? Anyone from the class, why do we need to measure it immediately and to protect it from direct sunlight? Vampire ka girl, ayaw mo ng sunlight? Okay, I am seeing answers here. Okay, ang sagot nila ay bilirubin is denatured by light, photosensitive. Okay, I just want to correct this. Tama yung thought, pero mali yung term. Denatured is not the term. It would be oxidized by light. Okay, it will be oxidized by light. That's why we need your, ayan, tama yung sabi ni Kit, photooxidation. So we call it photooxidation. So, that's why we store it in amber-colored bottles, okay? You know, the amber-colored bottles, we store your photosensitive reagents there. That's why you also have an amber-colored test tube where you can put your bilirubin in it, okay? So, visible icteria, okay, or visible icterusia is observed if there is greater than 20 milligrams per liter of bilirubin, okay? 25 milligrams per liter of your bilirubin. Remember this, guys. Okay, remember in the measurement of your bilirubin, okay, we're talking about the measurement of bilirubin here, huh? In the measurement of your bilirubin, we have this thing called your accelerator. And your accelerator can be in the form of your caffeine, benzoate, or your caffeine, and your methanol. which will be discussed later on when I classify the two types of methods used in bilirubin measurement. Okay? So, accelerants are used for us to be able to measure your B1. Okay? For us to measure your B1. Ito yung kwento niyan, guys. Okay? Please remember that when measuring your bilirubin, there are only two types of bilirubin directly measured. And I want you to write this on your notes right now. Number one are your total bilirubin. And the second one is your direct bilirubin. Again, let me repeat that. Your total bilirubin and your direct bilirubin, aka B2, aka water soluble, aka fast acting bilirubin. Nakukuha? So si direct bilirubin lang at si total bilirubin ang kaya mong i-measure sa laboratory. Sir, paano po ngayon si indirect bilirubin? Anyone who can explain to me how to compute the indirect bilirubin? How to compute the indirect bilirubin? Okay, magtatawag ako. Anong minus? Minus? Anong minus? How? By subtracting the value of your direct bilirubin from your total bilirubin. Okay, guys, ito yung kwento nun, ha. I'll translate it in Tagalog para makuha natin. When it comes to direct bilirubin, ang ginagawa natin, since hindi nga natin kaya i-measure si indirect or si B1, what we do first is to measure the direct. Si B2 muna ang mini-measure ko. Bakit? Kasi siya yung directly nagre-react. Saan? Directly nagre-react kay diazo reagent. Okay? Diazo reagent. So sa diazo reagent, pagdagdag ko ng diazo reagent, nagkakaroon agad ng azo or azo bilirubin. Okay? And that azo bilirubin is now measured, and that is now the value of your B2 bilirubin. Sir, paano po si B1 na left behind? Hindi po tama yan. Ganyan. Kanwari, nag-iinarte tayo ng ganon, di ba? Paano po si B1? Si B1, we will be adding your accelerators first. Accelerators such as what? Your methanol or your caffeine benzoate. Okay? Your methanol or your caffeine. So dahil dinagdag mo na ngayon si caffeine, dinagdag mo, or kung hindi si caffeine, si methanol, si indirect bilirubin will be converted now in the tube into your direct bilirubin. Nakukuha? It will be converted to direct bilirubin. And now, we can measure your total bilirubin. Okay? We can now measure your total bilirubin. And am I clear? And everybody, am I clear? Can I just see a raise of hand if I'm clear pa so far? Ang tagal ng oras, ha, in fairness. Okay? So, clear tayo dun, ha? Okay, thank you so much. So, bilirubin assay in general, mga kapanalig sa paniniwala, is governed by a principle, a reaction, which we call your Vandenberg reaction. Okay? Your Vandenberg reaction is the diazotization of your bilirubin to produce your azo bilirubin. Ito yung rason kung bakit may tinatawag tayo ngayong direct at indirect bilirubin. Why? Kasi tinawag siyang direct bilirubin. Okay, tinawag siyang direct bilirubin kasi pagkadagdag ko ng diazo reagent, ay amazing. 'Di ba? Pagdagdag ko ng azo bilirubin ng diazo reagent, ay amazing, 'di ba? Na-compute ko, nag-react agad siya. Kaya siya tinawag na direct bilirubin. Eh yung isa, pagkadagdag ng diazo reagent, ay no reaction, walang ganap. Then they realize that probably these are actually your unconjugated bilirubin. So nagdagdag sila ng caffeine, ng bilirubin, ay ng bilirubin, ng methanol, ng accelerator. That's the reason why dagdag pagdagdag mo ng aso bilirubin, it will now already react. Okay? So kung makikita nyo dito, bilirubin plus your diazo sulfanilic acid, your diazo reagent, plus your react accelerator, perfect. That is your total bilirubin. Okay? Bilirubin plus your diazo bilirubin is equal to azo bilirubin. This is your conjugated bilirubin. This is your B2. This is your direct bilirubin. Okay? So to compute for the indirect or the unconjugated bilirubin, how do we do that? We compute it by first getting the oh my gosh, I forgot the difference. Okay. You get the difference between your total bilirubin and your conjugated bilirubin. Okay? So that in turn will give you your unconjugated bilirubin. Okay? Your unconjugated bilirubin. So clear tayo, mga kapanalig sa paniniwala? Are we clear? Hello? Are we clear? Kasi ito na yung ano, ito na yung foundation ng dalawang principle. Are we clear? Can I see a raise of hands, guys? If we're clear, Kerry? Okay. So having said that now, there are two types of bilirubin assay. These two types of bilirubin assay differ from one another sa iisang bagay lang. The accelerator that they are using. The first one is si Evelyn and Malloy or your Evelyn Malloy method. Yung ito guys ha, itong nakikita niyo dito sa screen, makikitingin sa screen kung sumusubo ka ngayon, chine-check mo yung IG mo or chine-check mo yung message ng jowa mo, ito muna. Okay? Dito sa screen na to, this is the general reaction for both of the methods. Okay? Both of the methods. So in Evelyn Malloy, anong ganap ni ating maring Evelyn at ni Malloy? Ang accelerator nila is 50% methanol. Okay? 50% methanol. And the reagents are as follows. And the final reaction is the pink to purple azo bilirubin. Okay? Pink to purple azo bilirubin. Methanol, pink to purple azo bilirubin, Evelyn and Malloy. Girl si Ate Evelyn, kaya pink to purple ang paborito niyang kulay. Okay? Next is your gendrasic growth method. This is the most common method currently. Why? Because of a lot of things later that I will be mentioning. Okay? So it is the most it is a popular technique in most of your discrete analyzer. Bakit siya mas preferred? Because it's more sensitive than your Evelyn Malloy, meaning to say, it can measure low levels of your bilirubin. Aside from that, it is not affected by pH changes and it's not affected by hemoglobin, meaning to say, if the hemolysis is within that 750 milligrams per DL below, sige, comparing gendrasic growth can still measure your bilirubin accurately. Nakukuha po tayo? Nakukuha ko doon ha? Okay, question. Tanong ko lang ha, tingnan ko lang kung gaano katindi yung mga brain powers natin right now. What carbohydrate method is not affected by your ascorbic acid and bleach? And this is considered to be the reference method for your glucose measurement. Ay, mabilis. Anong sagot? Okay, very good guys. That is your hexokinase method. Okay? That is your hexokinase method. So, gendrasic and growth. Okay? Anong pinagkaiba mga kapanalig? Ang pinagkaiba niya ay, okay, ang pinagkaiba niya, is the accelerator. Ang accelerator natin dito is your caffeine, sodium, benzoate. Caffeine, sodium, benzoate. Ano pang importante at mahalaga sa gendrasic growth is the presence of your sodium acetate. Your sodium acetate, on the other hand, is what? Your sodium acetate is a type of buffer that prevents pH changes. Tama. And aside from that, you also have ascorbic acid. Your ascorbic acid terminates, terminates the initial reaction and destroy the excess diazo reagent. Okay? So, para walang interference, sa bilirubin measurement, dendritic growth, meron tayo niya. Guys, I want you to remember what is the function of your caffeine benzoate, the function of your sodium acetate, pakibilugan na yan, and the function of your ascorbic acid. At dahil si Kuyang dendritic growth ay lalaki, ayan, so pink to blue naman siya. Pink to blue, pink to purple yung isa. Okay? So, I'll just finish things up. I think I can naman. The rest that I will not be able to discuss, I will be sending it to you via video. Okay? And lahat ng liver function, siguradong kasama sa finals. Okay? Next, we have your bilirubinometry. Your bilirubinometry is a new generation of bilirubinometer na you just have to put it on the skin of the baby. Ayan. So it involves the reflected light from the skin using two wavelengths that provide the numerical index based on the spectral reflectance. Diba? Ang sabi. So the new generation bilirubinometers use microspectrophotometers. So pag tinanong ko, sino yung gumagamit ng microspectrophotometers? Alam mo na. Okay? So, moving on, so with what we discussed sa bilirubin, that in itself pa lang is already the the test that you can use to actually identify if there is jaundice. And 'di ba napakahalaga nga kanina, 'di ba? We were able to classify which one is hepatic, prehepatic, and posthepatic with the level of bilirubin. And ako, sinasabi ko na sa inyo, ganun ako magpa-exam. I would give a particular level. You would say if it is hepatic, prehepatic, posthepatic, alongside with the diseases and the hepatic, like your Gilbert, Krigler, DJ, Rotor, kayang-kaya nyo yan. Okay? So, before I go and before we end, let me just continue the last part. So, meron pa pala, di ba? Is the bromosulfantaline dye excretion test. Okay? So, what is this test for? This test is for the hepatocellular function and the potency of your bile duct. Specifically, it's excretion function. Okay? It's excretion function. There are two ways on how to do this. We can have your Rosenthal White, which is a double collection. And we also have your McDonald's single collection. Okay? Siguro nagutom ka. So treat yourself with McDonald's, okay? At isang Happy Meal. So your Rosenthal White are two doses. So you collect after 5 and 30 minutes. Similar to what, ano yung two dose sa OGTT? Ano yung two dose sa OGTT, children? What is the two dose in OGTT? Okay, tama. It's your X-tone rose. Anong pala tandaan ko doon? Yung X-tone 2 T, X-tone T, T, 2, T-W-O, yun. So, X-tone rose for the double dose in OGTT. Okay? So, we have your Rosenthal White and we have your McDonald's. So, in McDonald's naman,
yung... Sir, nakamute po ata kayo.
Where? Okay. One moment. I'll just fix the problem.
Sir, wala pa po.
Kalma lang. OMG. Alam nyo, 0304, per good choice na dito ako sa inyo nag-record ngayon. Kasi kung hindi, mauulit yung nangyari sa akin sa HIMA. I recorded a lecture na nakamute yung mic. So. There. Can you hear me now? Hello? Can you hear me now?
Yes, po.
Okay. So, I'll just try to present my screen, no? So, ayun nga, going back to what I was saying kanina, when it comes to your, McDonald, which is a single method, you just have to collect that after 45 minutes, okay? After 45 minutes. So, the purpose of this, okay, the purpose of this is for us to be able to identify how much of the dye is actually excreted. Dapat wala na siya sa katawan mo after 45 minutes. So if it remains there, meaning to say, there is a problem with the excretion function. Nakukuha ako. There's a problem in the excretion function of your liver. Okay? So aside from that, so aside from excretion, you can, aside from your bromsoftaline dye excretion method, you can also do your urobilinogen. Okay? Your urobilinogen is a colorless end product after the reduction of your conjugated bilirubin, oxidation of your bacteria in your intestine, forming now your urobilin, the brown pigment on your stool. So either excreted in the urine or, diba, remember 20% are reabsorbed, that's why it would now also be seen in your urine. Okay, so complete biliary obstruction would cause the absence of your urobilinogen in your stool and in your urine. Ergo, if you have a clay colored stool, ang color ng stool mo ay parang clay, walang, hindi siya brown, that is a sign of biliary obstruction. Okay? Biliary obstruction. So, we also have, so the specimen here should be a 2-hour freshly collected urine or stool. And you would now perform the test using your Ehrlich method. Okay? Using your Ehrlich method, using your P-dimethylaminobenzaldehyde reagent or your PDAB. I guess you have heard this in your AUBF, correct? Narinig niyo sa AUBF yan. So this is the reference interval for your urobilinogen, okay? For your urobilinogen. So again, urobilinogen for obstruction, similarly with your bromsoftaline method. Okay? Bromsoftaline method. Amazing ha, ini-expect ko magta-time na pero ang dami ko pang time. Meron pa akong 7 minutes. Dahil diyan, What do you say? Ang arte, di ba? May topak lang. Wait lang ha. I cannot see your ano. Yung which one? The Ehrlich? What's the matter with the... Alin ba? Yung Ehrlich ba? Di ba EH naman talaga? Alam nyo, pinaka-hate kong isang bagay, mag-spell. So, Ehrlich. EHR. Dapat. EHR. EHR. Okay, so moving on. Okay, sayang yung 1 minute ko. Okay, so let's go now to the measure of the detoxification. Mabilis lang naman to. When it comes to the measurement of the detoxification function, guys, tapos na tayo sa conjugation, excretion, tapos na tayo sa detoxification. Maganda yon para mamaya yung i-discuss ko is all about synthetic function na lang. Kasi yun yung mas mahaba. So, in the detoxification function, this is now, when we say detoxification, we're trying to make something not toxic into a less toxic substance. One toxic substance in the body is actually your ammonia. So, when it comes to detoxification, it involves enzymes and ammonia test. So what enzymes are we gonna perform? We can actually perform your ALT, AST, and even your GGT, okay, and a lot more. But the ultimate measure of your detoxification function, makikisulat na lang ako ha, the ultimate measure of your detoxification function is the ammonia level. Okay? The ammonia level. So, these enzymes are used, yung enzymes natin, balikan ko lang na mabilis, like this one that are shown here, we have your AST, ALT, ALP, and GGT. AST, your aspartate transaminase. ALT, alanine transaminase. Your ALP, your alkaline phosphatase. And your GGT, which is your glutamyl transferase, gamma glutamyl transferase. Okay? So, those are the things that I want you to remember. So, all of these enzymes, lagi niyong tatandaan, pagdating niyo sa clinic, sa CC2, pag tinanong ng professor ninyo, why are we using enzymes in diagnosing disease? Okay? Ito yung sagot. Because we are using enzymes in the diagnosis of diseases because during disease state, okay, during disease state, these enzymes are abnormally secreted by your cells. Okay? So, kunwari, dahil nga may problema yung hepatocytes mo, sa hepatocytes mo, lahat ng AST, ALT, GGT, ALP, pinakawalan niya sa plasma. Kaya mataas sila sa iyong blood. Okay? So, in cases of liver, cell destruction or cell injury, okay, ayan, injury to the liver result to cytolysis and necrosis causes the liberation of various enzymes. And these various enzymes are your, andito pala, di ba? Your alkaline phosphatase, your aminotransferases like your aspartate aminotransferase and your alanine. You also have your 5-nucleotidase, your gamma glutamyl transferase, your ornithine, your LAP, and your LDH. Ayan. So, I think later, mababanggit ko pa naman yung iba dyan, especially in relation to your liver function. Okay? In relation to your liver function. But for now, ayan. Let's go to your ammonia first. So, it is the main test to detect if there is in the liver is no longer in with capability in detoxifying your ammonia. So your ammonia arises from the deamination of your amino acids. Pero saan ba nangyayari yung deamination ng amino acids? Ano bang problema natin? Ba't may deamination ng amino acids? Deamination of the amino acids happen in your liver. Okay? And in return, di ba, yung lalabas na NH3 dun sa amino acid mo, di ba, ang amino acid mo may COOH, alpha carbon, then the reactive group, and then meron kang amino group. The amino group, when removed, okay, it will now become your ammonia. Ammonia is not good for your body because ammonia is toxic to your brain and toxic to your kidneys. Okay? So, your liver normally will remove most of your non-protein nitrogenous compounds via your portal vein circulation. Dadaan sila doon, it convert your urea, it will convert your ammonia into becoming your urea, which is a less toxic waste, but still a waste that needs to be eliminated from your body through your urine. Okay? So this is the reference value. So I want you guys to remember that when it comes to ammonia, the specimen of choice should be collected in your green top tube that contains your heparin. Sir, lithium or sodium? The answer is your lithium heparin. Okay? It is your lithium heparin. And makikisulat ng malaking ballpen, lakihan mo na. Okay? Eh, with regards to ammonia, ammonia is a marker of hepatic failure. Okay, it is a marker of your hepatic failure. It's already 12 noon, so let me just finish up this last two slides. So in ammonia, you can perform your Kel-Dal test. Okay, you can perform Kel-Dal test. In Kel-Dal's test, what you are measuring are the number of nitrogen. Okay, the number of nitrogen you are measuring that in your KELDAL test. We will be mentioning that later on when I discuss albumin and total protein. We also have your Nestlerization. Okay, hindi ito paggawa ng Nestle products, kundi this is a reaction that involves your gum gati. Okay, and the color is yellow. Okay, yellow or orange brown kung madami, sobrang taas ng ammonia. We also have your Berthelot's method. Okay, your Berthelot's method, which is for the addition of your sodium nitroprusside. This one naman color blue siya. Berthelot blue. Berthelot color blue. Okay? Si Nestlerization color red, ay color yellow. Kayo na bahalang mag-isip kung ano yung Nestlerization. Okay? So, and last but not the least is your glutamate transferase. Okay? Your glutamate transferase, which is an enzymatic method. The rest are all chemical methods. Si KELDAL, Nestlerization, Berthelot. The only enzymatic method in the measurement of ammonia is your glutamate dehydrogenase. Okay, your glutamate dehydrogenase. So, guys, thank you so much for listening. Thank you so much for participating in class. So, I still have my last utang with you, which is a video of the synthetic function of your liver. So, I will be ending I'll end the recording already. Okay, I'll end the recording to entertain some of your questions. So do you have any questions?